Hello! In this video, I'll show you how to use our professional and modern-looking free resume templates on our website. We'll walk through everything from downloading them on your computer to customizing them in Microsoft Word. First, head over to resumegenius.com and click on Resumes from the top menu. Select Free Resume Templates and scroll down to Free Resume Templates to print and download. If you can't find the free templates, make sure to check out the instructions below. Once the file is downloaded, unzip the file and you'll find the template design in different colors, as well as the fonts we used for the resume. For the best results, make sure these fonts are installed before opening the document. If you open the template without installing the font first, you might need to restart Microsoft Word for the fonts to show up. Once the fonts are set up, open the template with the color you like. To edit your document, you may need to click the Enable Editing option at the top of the screen. Once enabled, you can quickly fill in your name, job title, and contact information. Most of our templates use tables because they keep the content neat and easy to edit. Before you start editing, you should make these table borders visible to have a better idea of what's going on. To do this, first click on any resume content on the template. Then, go into the newly appeared Layout tab and toggle the View Gridlines option on. Now you can easily add entries for sections. Let's say you found this resume objective example from this page and wanted to paste it into the template. Make sure you're pasting it without formatting with the Shift-Ctrl-V shortcut to avoid any issues. You can do the same for the rest of your sections. If you want to add a new work experience, first select the number of rows you want to add, right-click, and choose Insert Rows Above. Now you can copy an existing entry and paste it here, then customize the text as needed. If some of the formatting gets lost in the process, you can fix it with the Format Painter tool under the Home tab. For example, when I paste some bullet points here, the spacing looks weird. To fix it, I can just click on a row with the correct spacing, pick up the Format Painter, and apply it to the weird-looking row. To delete unnecessary rows, just right-click on them and select Delete Rows. Once you're done adding content, adjust the table borders to fit the text neatly inside one page. However, I don't recommend overcomplicating the template with too many added sections or formatting. You can always go back to our website to find a template that fits your needs the best. After finishing up the final adjustments, toggle View Gridlines off again from the Layout tab to see how your resume looks like. Make sure everything's tidy with no typos, incorrect information, or leftover placeholders. The second page has links to all the resources you need for your application. Need help with typing bullet points for your past experiences? We have resume samples that you can use as reference for almost every industry. And if you need a cover letter to go with your resume, we got you covered with our free templates for that as well. When you're all done, right-click on this page and select Delete Rows to remove it before exporting the resume. We don't recommend sending your resume as a Word doc file because hiring managers might not have some of the fonts installed and the file might look messy as a result. Instead, use the Save as Adobe PDF option to preserve the formatting. Make sure to attach this PDF file to the job application and not the Word doc. If this guide helps you out, please like, share, and subscribe.